Okay, so we're going to have a little look at something called definite loops. So the idea behind a definite loop is that what it will do is it will repeat something a certain amount of times. Okay, so let's say we wanted to bowl an over in cricket. We would repeat our bowling action 6 times and then we would stop. Okay, so it repeats a thing for a certain amount of times. All right. Now, the code you need for this looks slightly strange. Here it is. Okay. So, what will happen here, just to explain, is it looks a bit weird, but what we've got is X is what we call the counter. Okay. So this will count up or down depending on what we tell it to do. Now, the first number in the brackets here, this is the start number of our counter. So it's going to be the start number of X. Okay, so we're going to tell X to start counting at 1. The middle number is the end number of X. Okay, so this is the number X will count up to, but not including. Okay, and the last number, where it says 1, is what we call the step value. Okay, so this is how much X will go up by each time. Okay, so what we've said for X here is every time the loop runs, we're going to start at 1, we're going to count up to but not including 10, and we're going to count up in 1s. So have a think of what we're going to get when we run this program. What will X be first? Okay, so we've said it's going to start at 1, so X should be 1. Then it should count all the numbers through up to but not including 10. So let's have a look by pressing the play button over here. And there we go, there's the output. So you can see X has repeated and it's counted up by 1 each time until it gets to 9 up there, but not including 10. Okay, so this is how to count using X. Now, next step here is we could count up and we could count up to anything. So we could count up, let's say, to 1,000, and we could count up in 2s. All right, so let's run and see what we get this time. Lots of numbers. Okay, there we go. So you can see here it's counted up in 2s all the way from 1 to 1,000. Okay, so this is the step number 2 here. If we were to reduce this back to 10 and we started at the number 2, okay, so X is going to be 2 to start with. It's going to go up 2 but not including 10, and it's going to count up by 2 each time. Let's see what we get. Okay, so we effectively get part of the 2 times table. Now let's say we wanted the 2 times table up to 100. We can go up by 2, we can start at 2, and we can go up to but not including 100. If we wanted to go to 100, we'd put 101 in. Okay, so let's try that out. So there's the 2 times table up to 100. So how could we get the 9 times table? Well, let's have a look. So if I change that back to a 1, and this time we want to count up in 9s. So I'm going to put 9 as our step value. So let's see what happens now. Okay. So you can see there it's counting up in 9s, but it's not quite the 9 times table because we started at 1. So let's try amending this to start at 0. And let's see what happens. Okay, that looks a bit better. We could even start at 9. Okay, so we could adjust our start value to start at 9, go up to 101 and go up by 9s. There we go, and we've got the 9 times table. So can you do the 8 times table and the 7 times table? OK. Okay. So see how you get on with that. Once you're done, check back for the next video. So here's your instructions. Print the 8 times table. Print the 9 times table. Oh no, we've done 9, haven't we? Let's go for 7. Okay, so try those out, and when you're done, have a look at the next video.